for you sometime next week.
Thank you.
Yeah. GG's.
Should I hop in? Are you guys cutting stream with this, or?
We actually have another race.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
that's right. We've got one more race happening for you this evening. It will be the 7-seed Devolition Derby versus the 9-seed I Like Being Smart. So give us a few minutes to set that one up.
It's 10 a.m. to 7 p.m.
Okay, that could be workable around probably.
Yeah, that's right. It's possible.
And I'm gonna hop out of here now. Thanks for having me.
Oh yeah, all right. Thanks for the races. Good luck in the future.
Thank you.
All right, so everybody stay tuned. Cards is going to be working on the format for this next race, but we will have number 7 seed Devolition Derby versus number 9 seed I Like Being Smart, so stay tuned. I will be right back, cards.
Yes, take as much time as you need. All right. Okay. So it looks like Forky will be coordinating with the two runners here to get the next race started. Meanwhile, I will work on layouts. So this will take a little bit of time to get the proper information out. This race did go a little bit longer than expected, but it was definitely a close match, which is ultimately what we like to see. Okay. Definitely gonna see an upgrade in PBs for this round, but I can't imagine that it's going to be any more competitive now than it was in this previous match. Let's see. It appears I Like Being Smart's not live yet. That's okay.
I think she went to like the bathroom or went off to do something for the time being, but I think she'll be back soon.
Yeah, that's fair. All right. This gives me time to capture Dev's stream. All right. like I still have a little bit more work on the actual race layout before we try and do this again for a future tournament, because I think we're gonna try this thing where we have multiple tournaments like this and space them out every 3 to 4 months or so, I believe, is the current goal.
Yeah, we'll have plenty of time to figure out the next one. Also, if you don't know the rest of the matchups for this week, tomorrow's obviously us. I should be able to figure out. It might not be on Montucky's stream, actually, so I'll give you a holler at the end of this next race. And then I think Alta and Lightnings is going to be sometime Saturday. I want to say like maybe 6 or 7 p.m. Eastern.
Yes. Yes, they were talking about some sort of evening time slot for that.
Montucky and Thomas and Darkwing and Edo, I'm not sure. I'll have to contact both of them, and maybe we can get them all. Maybe we can get a triple header on Saturday. That'd be pretty cool.
Nice way to close out the week for sure. Alright, that'll do. We'll fully admit that Dev's timer is a bit weird. Okay. Gotten somewhat conscious about Twitter handles after realizing that I've constantly botched Montucky's handle for the longest time. Keep forgetting that underscore, man. That damn underscore.
Yeah, I usually just wait for like the like suggestion to pop up, because it'll usually pop up his, or else I'd probably forget it too.
All right, Nicole is live and capping her stream now. So, Mr. Forks, how do you expect this particular matchup to play out?
Oh, God. Now, this is going to be one of the most toughest ones that I have to deal with right now. Obviously, it looks like Dev's going to be the overwhelming favorite just based on PB. I mean, it's not too much better, but it is like a sub-9 as compared. Hers is like a mid-930-something, I want to say. I don't have your stream
up
right
now. Yeah, she got down to 922.
Here's the thing with this. I think Dev is like pretty hot. He'll get always a consistent time, but it's either like pretty hot to where it's a low 9 to a high 8, or it's probably like a low 11 to a high 10. So I think the pace is going to be determined on how well he does. And Nicole is one of the most consistent people I know when it comes to Puzzle League games. She won't get the quickest time for sure, but it will always be like that low 10 minute to high 9 minute range, like almost every time, because she just is really consistent with whatever she does. So I don't know, like, both these guys are pretty good friends to me, but if I had to pick one person, you know what, I'm gonna go with Dev.
You know what, I think I'm willing to step on a limb here. I'm going to put my hat behind Nicole for this one, cause I do find at times during Dev's runs that he can have a little bit of trouble setting up his combos during his chains effectively, and Nicole I find to be so much better at actually looking for all of those combos. It's definitely her extensive Pokemon Puzzle League experience at play there. She really loves to especially look for all the four combos, which don't necessarily stack that well, but I think she can get her garbage to stack effectively enough. So I think Nicole is actually going to take this.
Yeah, I can agree with a lot of what you're saying. Like, basically, I say it comes down to Dev. If he plays the best he can, he will take it. If he's, like, not even... Like, even if he's playing medium, I don't think he'll take it, because just Nicole's that consistent. Mm. But I have faith. I've been hanging around with him a lot the past couple weeks, and I'm like... I've been motivating him a little bit. And he got kind of close to Montucky last week, so I think he's looking to rebound right now.
All right, the racers are now underway. Let's see how they handle this first stage. And Dev, finding a 7 combo to start. He's got a pretty nice chain lined up. Nicole dropped her chain a bit early, but found a good follow-up. Oh, and looks like Nicole's just good. Oh, the force kill from Dev. Oh, that was a little unexpected. I thought it was just gonna be Nicole waiting for stop time to run out. She would run off to the quick early lead, but it is Dev getting the force kill and the early 6-second advantage.
Kind of similar to what we saw last time. These guys will not be getting too big of leads on each other. Like, even compared to the last racers, both of these were seated a little bit higher. But any combination of the four could take races off each other. That's just how close they are in skill. So going into this second one right now, it looks like Dev unfortunately bumped to get the clear on him. But Nicole managed to get that sub 20 with the 18 second there, and will retake the lead right here.
Very, very, very nice. Looks like Dev was having a little bit of trouble filling the stack because Bumpty was clearing a little more than he usually does, but Dev does manage to get through with the 37. Ooh, that was a nifty little switch for Nicole there to start that chain against Poochie, but I'm not sure if she was half expecting it, so she didn't know how to follow up afterwards. But looks like, oh yeah, Nicole definitely made up a lot of ground with her follow-up chain, and she's gonna get the 20-second Poochie, and Dev making up some ground with the 16. Get the feeling we're gonna be seeing a bunch of those going forward. This match should not get away from either competitor, I think.
And that's a little bit what I was talking about before the match right there. I think that's what defines Dev when he plays this game. He can either get those sub 20-second fights, which are really, really good, or if he doesn't quite start off too well, those will usually go up to the 30 or the 40 second range.
Ooh, and Nicole's gonna have to wait for some stop time to run out before Wiggler goes down in 29 seconds. Just a little unfortunate that Wiggler found a clear of the garbage there. Definitely one of the biggest time wasters you can find, but Dev's time being wasted a bit here by this Wiggler, who continues to find ways to get out of out of these situations. Oh no, Dev. Oh, let's see. It looks like Nicole is having a little trouble getting enough follow-ups here to fill Froggy's stack, and now it's Dev moving on to Froggy himself. There's definitely an opportunity for time to be made up here. See what Dev does with this. Ugh. Couldn't get the greens around in time for a 6-chain. That might have had an opportunity to kill Froggy too.
Yeah, Nicole with a pretty nice follow-up chain. She might get lucky here and maybe get a kill on Froggy. Oh, the barely didn't send it
off.
No. One more line would have took him out. And just like that, Dev takes the lead right back as Nicole's going on a minute plus on the stage with another not top off, but she does get lucky and managed to get the kill at the last second there. But a minute and 8 is not what she wants right now.
She cannot be happy about that at all. She tends to wear her emotions on her sleeve a bit with Puzzle League. She will not be pleased. She's got to remember to keep a bit of a level head. And looks like Nicole's finding a good follow up to fill her Blarg's stack here. Dev having to fish a little bit more. He doesn't quite have Blarg topped off, but Nicole's Blarg just finding more ways to clear stuff, and it will be Dev moving on past Blarg first with a 39 and a 40 from Nicole, not losing too much ground here. It is still much too early to call this match.
I think with most of the races we've been seeing by people who are so evenly skilled, like especially these people, like the losers round is just filled with everyone who's basically the same seed. And these beginning 8 stages will always be really close. You'll hardly see someone get off to a really substantial lead. And Dev gets the really nice 21 second on Lunchfish there, and it looks like he will extend the lead a little bit more as Nicole is having some trouble finding or sending some garbage here.
Oh my. While she continues to struggle with Lunchfish, let's see how Dev does against Raphael here. He's got some pretty solid combo building going on there, but didn't have enough behind the chain to really make a difference there, so his follow-up is going to have to be enough to get the 20. Still, really, really solid finish to that stage from Dev, and poor Nicole just continuing to sit through this minute-long Lunchfish fight. She's clearing shock panels, which only show up after a certain amount of time. That's how you know the stage is going really, really slowly.
Yeah, maybe I should keep my mouth quiet for some of the stuff, because as soon as I say it's hard to get a stage lead in the first couple of 8 stages, she got trolled and Dev pulled away with some very quick fights, which we don't like to see for sure. We want to make sure these guys get like the best time they possibly can, and it sucks when you see stages just go that long.
Well, Nicole's finding a good follow-up here. Nice little 5-chain and another chain immediately afterwards. This is something I noticed quite a bit with Nicole's runs as she will get the force kill at 24. Dev moving on to Piranha Plant with a 35 hook bill. I'm finding with Nicole's chain, she falls into the trap of starting a new chain immediately, like doing it way too fast. She's not letting her combo garbage from the chain drop immediately, and I'm finding that it's costing her a few good quick stages here.
Yeah, it it's a little bit of a panic situation where, you know, you drop your first chain or something, a little bit of combos are sent, and you just were like, well, this isn't what I wanted to do. I didn't want to drop it this quick. And you're like, I need to find something really urgent, which sometimes leads you into the wrong situation because you need to let things drop a little bit beforehand. I know she plays a lot of Puzzle League, and you don't really have to be that patient. It's right. Kind of like watching the opponent's screen. But in this game, you have to make sure if you're sending combo garbage, wait a little bit before you start your next chain or more combos being sent.
All right, Dev is on a solid run here. He's got a six chain with a couple of four combos on this Kamek. That's not going to be enough to fill his stack, but Devolition Derby looking to pin Kamek down here and get out to an early lead in this match, and he gets Kamek into a force kill for the 31. So he will be poised to take a sub 10 going into Bowser, but if he gets trolled, Nicole's just now one stage behind. She
made up a lot of time with that 20 second piranha there, so it's anyone's game. If Bowser likes to do what he likes to do, I've seen him go for 3 minutes, 2 minutes, and we'll see what it comes down to. But Dev definitely has a really good lead here, and he sent a good amount of garbage at the beginning here. He's going to need to find a really good follow-up to secure this kill, though.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. The stack was a little high there for Dev. I cannot help but be a little worried when the stack gets that high.
Yeah, that's the last thing you want is a death at Bowser, because you don't know where your opponent's at right now. You could be in the driver's seat, and then all of a sudden your big lead turns into you being behind. And he's struggling a little bit here. Bowser does not have a lot of garbage. Nicole is struggling as well, too. She can't top off Kamek. Could easily make up a lot of time right now as Bowser is just going to town. Let's see how big this chain's going to be.
Oh, no. Oh, jeez.
Nicole gets the kill on Kamek, and I don't know if Dev sent enough, he could get the kill here, but if not...
Oh, no! You've got to kid me. Nope. Bowser's just continuing to find clears. Oh, boy.
Oh, good lord. Nicole's back in this with this one. She could maybe snipe a quick Bowser kill as... I don't think Dev still has Bowser topped off.
That I cannot... I don't have enough words to express...
Uh-oh.
Oh, jeez. Wow.
Nicole with a pretty good chain. Is Bowser going to die on Dev's screen? Another chain here. Oh, Bowser could be in for a force kill on Nicole's screen. This is so close. Oh, and Dev gets the kill.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow.
If Nicole sent a little bit more there, she would have got a force kill as well.
No.
And she might have been able to snipe the victory by half a second or so.
Oh, no. And now she's just going to sit here even longer, waiting to build enough garbage. Oh, wow. Wow, that could have gone down. That could have gone to either competitor there, But solid time. Solid time from Dev, and he will get the first point in this best of three.
Oh man, that was some close stuff there at the end. Like, Nicole was off to a pretty good start, and she just needed, I think it was two more lines. And I don't know if she would have took that victory, because Dev's Bowser died shortly after. But man, that would have been within a second, I guarantee.
Wow, it never ceases to amaze me how close these end games get with as random as these opponents can be, as trolly as Bowser has a tendency to be. A bunch of these matches, a huge chunk of them are going down to the final stage. It never ceases to amaze. Ugh, Nicole, 2 minutes on this this Bowser fight right now. Ugh.
Yeah, as we were talking about Bowser trolling earlier, he kind of did his work to both of the competitors here. Dev's almost 2 minutes, and Nicole's going into the 2 minute range. Hopefully she can get the kill here soon, but Bowser's still clearing a lot. He won't have anything set up immediately here, so she might be able to get the kill. There we go.
Alright. Alright. 2:29 Bowser from Nicole, and she will finish with a time of 13 minutes 20 seconds. Oh man, both. Yeah, like you said, Bowser just going in on both players, at least doing the job of keeping things really interesting. Okay. So that puts DevolitionDerby on game point. Another win, and he will move on to face the winner of Edobean and Darkwing Duck.
And as we saw with that last match, it's definitely pretty favored for Dev right now. But if Nicole can keep it calm, just, you know, shake off last match, kind of like how Flag did earlier. He made that 2-0 comeback, and she can easily win this set still. I think she was doing pretty good at the end, excluding Bowser, who was just kind of trolling for a while, but her cave was pretty solid as she was making up time. If she can just get some better confirms at the beginning game and get a little bit of a lead, she should be able to take the second game.
Yeah, and she's still doing that thing where she's starting a second chain way too quickly after finishing the first chain, and a bunch of her garbage is not dropping as soon as it could possibly be. That's something she's gonna want to look at going forward. I don't know if it'll necessarily be correctable for this match, but that's definitely something that could be holding her back in this game. You have to exercise some patience when you are trying to chain. You want to look for the garbage indicators in the opponent's queue above their screen. You gotta look for all those to go away before you start with another chain. Because if you try to chain multiple chain sequences together, like one right after the other, the combo garbage won't fall right away. So you have to be careful about that.
Yeah, patience is such a big factor in this, and it could be just part of the fact of transitioning from this to Puzzle League, but if she keeps it a little bit more cool and just looks for her chains and combos, you know, waits a little bit. If I didn't send enough this first time, well, let's wait until the whole thing drops down and then send a little bit more. You know, while you're waiting for your combo garbage to drop, it is a good time to just hold that R or L button, raise your stack a little bit, and then be like, all right, where am I going to start my next chain? And I'll have plenty of blocks to send even more garbage. Like, it's good to send a lot at the beginning, and if you think the opponent's going to be clear, don't leave yourself with little blocks. Mm-hmm. Get yourself some more blocks and keep going to town, basically.
Yeah, I noticed at the start of Dev's stages, he likes to go all out with maximizing his potential combos. He will flatten the stack as he's trying to raise the stack like up towards the panic level, but like one step below that. Whereas Nicole seems to just go straight for the first combo she finds and starts her chain with that. So there could be something to be said for trying to set things up ahead of time and maximize your chain potential.
All right, and as we're saying that, our next race is underway, and hopefully Nicole can rebound a little bit from this. Right now we got Dev starting off with a little bit of a drop chain, Nicole, a little bit too. They're kind of like a little bit even right now, but Dev with a really good follow-up manages to get a 17 on Lakitu and will take a lead heading into this match.
Very, very nice, and I'm not sure, Forky. I think you've gotten ahead of my stream just a little bit because I had to sync these streams a bit.
Oh, gotcha. So, I'll delay it a little bit. I just have the Twitch pops that pop out. So
right.
You have to teach me. You use like VLC for the syncing or something. I'll need to figure out how to use that.
It's a bit CPU intensive, but certainly works better for stream control. That's for sure. But all right, Dev getting through this Bumpty with a 25. Oh, Nicole's. I don't think Nicole's gonna. Okay. Bumpty went for a different color than I thought he was going to get, and then Nicole finishes Bumpty with a 27.
So Dev breaking off to a little bit of a lead right now. Nothing out of the ordinary. Slightly better stages on both of them. Right now he's having a little bit of trouble popping off Poochie here, but you know what Poochie does. You can't ever have a good Poochie stage.
Yeah, even the Poochie in my record run was a 20, which is certainly not the best you could possibly have.
Yeah, above average compared to the rest of them.
Yeah, for sure. All right, looks like Nicole has a Poochie topped off very nicely here for the 30. Can't be too disappointed with that. And Dev trying to go in with a chain here. Looks like a couple of mid-size chains for Dev with a lot of combos behind him, and that is enough to take the 17. Like I said, it's a balance of combos and chains that will get you the most results for you. And Nicole, not making up a little bit of ground there with the 15. So these you can't count either of these players out right now.
Yeah, between the first stage was a little bit favored in Dev. I think he was like about 10 or so seconds faster. But every stage since that has been within 2 or 3 seconds, actually. Nicole gained a little bit of ground there, but both of these people have been back and forth the entire time.
Oh, Nicole with the PPL strats with the combo garbage down really low there. Unfortunately, Froggy is able to chain out of it and find a way to clear it, and Dev's Froggy finally is ceasing his tirade of clearing and leaving Dev with, I think that was a 40, as Nicole gets through with a 37. Alright, there's Dev flattening the stack again, setting up a 5 combo like he usually does. Got a nice little chain going here, a 6, gonna go for 7, 8, and that, he should be happy enough with that. And there we go, a 17 from, a 17 on Blarg. That's about how you want to do it. That was some pretty masterful work there by Dev.
Yeah, it does not get much better than that. He managed to stay composed there, get a pretty nice sized chain, and Blarg really couldn't do anything about it as Nicole's trying to answer back a little bit here, and she will get a 30 second on Blarg.
Yeah, caught Blarg trying to raise to go to the top of the screen for a match. These opponents will scan from the top down looking for their matches, but if you catch them at the bottom of the screen like they tend to work in this game, and you get them to see matches at the top, you will catch a bunch of these opponents off guard that way.
Here's the break. Nicole can need Lunchfish playing with a high stack, and she will get the kill. 21 seconds. It looks like it's pretty much evened up right now.
Oh, yes. Again. Oh, yes. A 46 Lunchfish from Dev. Just absolutely hating on him there. And just like that, the lead is back in Nicole's hands. It looks like she's got something cooking for Raphael here. She's looking for another combo to follow that up with, but she keeps spamming these chains a little too fast, and not all of her garbage is dropping immediately. I don't think it would have mattered there, but it's still something to keep in mind. And just like that, Dev getting right back in front as both of these players now head into the cave, and Dev going with his trusty Raphael strats.
Hey, some people still just have their superstitions, man. If you use a different character, sometimes you just get some quicker kills. It works sometimes. I don't know why, but maybe it's just like the mindset it gives people.
It's kind of beyond our level of understanding, I suppose. I know the Japanese version of this game paled upon the record time in that category is a nice 23 from Dev there. So who knows? Maybe the strats do work, but the record paled upon run uses the character, I think, is Theana, the one normally in Poochie's position.
Interesting. Yeah, some people just have this preference, and it, you know, makes them play better, I guess. Maybe hearing different sound effects gives you a little bit more motivation. But both these competitors got a pretty quick hookbill fight. Dev with a little bit quicker, as he's going to have, it looks like, a 15 or 20-second lead right now.
Good 5-chain from Nicole to start off there. There's potential for a quick kill here. Oh, didn't quite send enough. Just one more line would have done it. And now it looks like Dev may be waiting for stop time of his own to run out before getting this kill here. But no, Piranha Plants just able to find so many more chains.
Man, he is going to town right now. And it looks like Piranha won't be topped off, I don't think. Yeah.
No. Wow, that was a nice 4-chain from that Piranha Plant, and Nicole's Piranha Plant runs out of time, getting the 45, and she will be in the driver's seat as we get to these last two stages.
Man, this race has been pretty back and forth as opposed to the last like five stages. Dev, like, he had this little bit of a lead, like 10 or 15 seconds, and extended it by like 2 seconds like every other stage, and then Nicole tied it up with a really good stage when Dev struggled, and now it's just been back and forth. And it looks like Dev might be able to close out Piranha pretty soon here.
Okay, he got the garbage to drop and force killed. Whew, that was almost really, really bad. And it looked like Nicole at the start of this Kamek fight here really made the most of a somewhat surprising situation. She was raising the stack and got a 6 combo from the rising panel. She was able to somehow find a 6 chain out of that nonsense, and she eventually turned that into what looked like a 39 Kamek there. So yeah.
And Kamek was looking to do some third tier, and then yes, the garbage dropped at the most appropriate time to where it messed up his cursor and couldn't get the clear, so Nicole managed to get the victory there.
Good stuff. That is why we love this game. Just so many little quirks like that in this AI. And nice little... Ooh, almost got the 7-chain. Nicole did. But, combo. Oh, not enough combo garbage there. Oh, she's gonna have to work a little bit harder. Oh. And Dev gets the force kill on Kamek, so... Nicole.
Oh!
No!
Is she gonna die? No! This is not good!
She was force killed!
She almost had Bowser force killed herself, but so unfortunate because that just turns the tide so much, and now Dev could close off this. Oh my.
Oh.
That's what you don't like to see there. And she can't be in the best mindset right now as Dev sent a really good chain to start off here.
Nice 7 chain to start there. That should keep Bowser busy for a while, but 6 chain of her own from the coal should keep her Bowser topped off. Ugh. That is such a way to end the run. She cannot be happy with that. And there's the 32 on Dev's Bowser.
Man.
DevolitionDerby will move on in this tournament, finishing with a time of 10 minutes, 54 seconds.
That one mistake there just meant so much at the end. You got to be really careful. You want to make sure Bowser's topped off, but at the same time, if you don't have the blocks to do it and you just send a little bit too much, then you just end your own life there, as we just saw. And that literally cost her the game.
And now she's got Bowser running out of stop time there, and she will finish the second race with a time of 11 minutes 35 seconds. but as close as that match was throughout, I'm slightly surprised that this went 2-0. Dev certainly was on his game for the most part, and I keep forgetting in the back of my mind that Dev is really good at incorporating combos into his chains. So he's usually much better at that than Nicole usually is. Nicole usually likes to go for a bunch of 4 combos during his chains, but Dev is much better at finding like 5s and 6s, and he just gets more consistent times that way. And
yeah, as we could saw, that second game could have went back and forth there, as we actually have Dev joining us in right now. Dev,
hello.
You probably don't know what happened during your second match, but
Nicole actually just got done telling me, and I just kind of was like, what? No way! Are you serious?
She almost had the force kill on Bowser, but she ran out of blocks herself, and she had the lead like the whole time in the cave.
Wow.
But that's what happens. You got to be careful with the blocks that you're playing with. And Dev, you managed to be pretty consistent there in pulling out the win. How'd you feel about both the races that you did today?
So I was a little unsatisfied with my first race, just because I felt like I was making a lot more mistakes than I usually do. But that second race, I felt like my chains and combos were just coming naturally to me, and every kill seemed really satisfying. So. And speaking of what you were saying, Forky, with Nicole being right with me up in the cave, I was on sub-8 pace, or not sub-8, I'm sorry, sub-9 pace, like, the entire time, up until Piranha Plant, so she was right there. She could have had that, and I'm, like, really satisfied with that race. That was, knowing the information now, I'm even more, like,
yeah, because neither one of us were watching the stream, so you guys have to fill us in on what happened.
So basically, if I could do a recap of both of the races.
Sure, absolutely.
Basically, from 1 to 8, pretty much even, lead switched a lot. At the end of the first race, Dev had like a 2-stage lead going into Bowser, but had that 2-minute stage, and you managed to like tie it back up for a little bit, but you got trolled on Bowser as well. So Dev pretty much handily won that second one. Or the first one. The second one, same thing at the beginning 8. You pulled out a little bit ahead at the end, Nicole. And then just that unfortunate Bowser death, or else you would have had it.
Fuck that dude! Pretty much. Yeah, I was disappointed because on the first race, if I remember right, because he got really, really aggro, and I had a chance, if I had sent enough, I could have won it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't realize I could have won the race, but I could have gotten a quick kill there because he basically cleared his entire stack and I just didn't send enough.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, God damn it. But I had no idea where I was in regards to like how far I was ahead or behind. I assumed the second race, I assumed I was even or maybe a little bit ahead, but the first race, I knew I was behind going into caves. Probably I knew I wasn't doing very well. So
yeah, and sometimes with the magnitude of these races, if you don't know whether you're ahead or not, it's like, well, do I do something risky here? Do I play more consistent? Because that can switch up a lot of the leads as well, because you're like, hey, I'm playing good, but I don't know if my opponent is as well.
Right.
So that
right.
could be a little bit of the factor.
It's nice to see my general sense of was pretty on. So, because I knew, like I said, going into caves, I knew I was behind, or somewhere in caves, I knew I was behind the first race, and I figured I was even or a little bit ahead the second race. So that's cool.
I definitely sensed Nicole at the end of the first race at Bowser. As Bowser started to troll me, I'm sitting there going, she's gonna dot done like any second now. And then like as the like every 10 seconds the fight kept going, I'm like, where's her dot done? There's no way.
Nope. And then I got trolled too, so.
Yeah.
Definitely some close races. From the two of you, and unfortunately, Nicole, we have to say goodbye to you in this tournament.
It's funny, Forky actually told me that I was gonna tear it up in loser's bracket, and I didn't believe him, and then I started playing well, and I was like, okay, sounds good, but I made it further than I thought I would did. I thought I'd win one round in losers, but I didn't think I would go this far, so I'm quite pleased with my performance, since TA isn't my main game.
Yeah, we were talking about that. We're seeing a little with the puzzly carryover, and I did mention this a lot. Was for like the losers bracket, a lot of like the higher up seeds kind of were in the bottom half as opposed to the upper half. And I told Dev this while you were away, but I'm like, I guarantee the winner of this match is going to win the next one as well, just because of the caliber of how you guys played last week during races and what I've seen the previous weeks during your other matches. So it's just unfortunate you both had to play each other, but we're getting into the thick of the tournament. So
absolutely,
right. Yeah.
So yeah, Dev, how are you feeling now that you get to await the winner of Edelbean and Darkwing Duck?
I'm actually really excited because that's the one fight I was actually hoping that I got to play, whether I win or lose, just because. Either of those people I've never raced against, Edelbean or Darkwing, and I'm really just excited to see how I do against it.
All right.
So I'm feeling pretty good though.
Good to hear. Good to hear. So yes, congratulations two of you for good showings in this tournament, good races tonight, and hopefully we'll be able to see you two around and Maybe you two will also join us for the next tournament we have which we hope to come along in about 3 months or so.
Oh, absolutely.
No
I'm
question.
Happy about this tournament because it actually encouraged me to hook up my Super Nintendo to stream, which is something I've been meaning to do forever but have been too lazy to do. Mm-hmm. But then it was like, no, you need to stream, and it's like, oh, okay. pregnancy hype. No, so it got me to stream, and now I can, if I want to randomly stream Super Nintendo games, I can do that. So that's pretty cool.
Good. And while Dev tends to his furry friends, we will go ahead and say goodbye to tonight's coverage of this tournament. We have one more match scheduled, confirmed in this next round of races that have to go in. It will be me. It will be BB Forky. It will be tomorrow. It will be hype. So
it's gonna be sick.
I am in between people who might be restreaming it. So if you follow myself or Cards or any of the other puzzle people, look out for a tweet tomorrow, because it'll it'll be known for sure. It'll probably be Montauk.
Hi!
And there's Bankai.
nice Bankai drive-by.
Bankai, what the? Bankai Senpai, we miss you.
But anyway, look I'm for back. Most likely Montucky's stream, but we'll confirm it tomorrow for sure. So yes. Any last thoughts from you cards or any of the for you, Dev or Nicole, on how you guys played today?
No, I'm just happy that the restream went well and happy that the races were as close as they were.
Absolutely. Ditto.
Good. And speaking of Montucky, his match with FFR Pro 21, which should be another great match to look forward to in winter semifinals. That has yet to be scheduled, and I don't think Darkwing and Edelbein have yet to schedule their match. But like Forky said, just follow him, follow me on Twitter, follow someone close to the puzzle community. We will be sure to get the information out on when those matches will be scheduled as soon as that information becomes available. But we're going to go ahead and close it out here for the night for BB Forky, Devolition Derby, I Like Being Smart, Bankai, and everyone else here at Puzzle General. Until next time, everyone, thanks for watching.
See you guys.
Peace. Thanks, everybody.